Breaking tonight, Dr. Ben Carson's star on the rise, his campaign announcing its best fundraising month to date, bringing in some $6 million in August, a month that is typically one of the worst for politicians trying to raise money. And then there's the recent Monmouth University poll out of the key battleground state of Iowa. Dr. Carson tied with Donald Trump there. We told you that the other night, followed by Fiorina, Cruz, and Walker rounding out the top five. Now the doctor finds himself facing a new bit of incoming. Brit Hume is our Fox News senior political analyst. Brit, good to see you. So before I get to what Trump is now saying about Dr. Carson, your thoughts on his rise and the reason for it?
Well, it suggests to me, Megan, that there's a volatility here in the polling and in public sentiment. Look, it is still very early, Megan. Sentiment is soft. Voters are fickle with the choices they make when questioned by pollsters. And if you look at the rise of Carson and the decline of Scott Walker in that Iowa poll, it kind of tells you all you need to know about this race. I don't think Scott Walker's, the voters in Iowa have really changed their minds completely about Scott Walker. It's just that sentiment is soft. And Ben Carson, you know, had a great outing in the debate in the sense that his closing statement really kind of brought the house down and everybody loved it. And he's been kind of reflecting that ever since. And so he's having his moment. Mm-hmm. Just as Herman Cain had his moment and Rick Perry had his moment.
Rick Santorum
had his moment and Newt Gingrich had his moment. They all took their turns in the front runner position in 2012 and they all faded.
But now that is a difference so far that we've seen with Donald Trump versus all those people you just mentioned, because his lead, his position atop the polls has been sustained so far much longer than we saw with those others.
Yeah, but he's not in the lead now in Iowa, is he?
Well, he's tied.
Well, I know, but that's not leading. I'm just saying
he's
that,
tied
that that's
for the
a,
lead.
Well, that's right. But that, look, that's not bad. He's still in the lead, but people are beginning to gain on him. Which wasn't happening before. All was happening is that people were all kind of bouncing around many points behind him. Now somebody's risen to challenge him. I'm just saying it's early. There'll be a lot of this. And how this plays out is a long way from being decided.
So it's no accident, most likely, that in an interview with the Daily Caller, Trump spoke of Dr. Carson today and began with the same line we heard about Jeb Bush. He talked about how he's nice and he's really a friend of mine. And he says, though, I just think it's a very difficult situation that he puts himself into. To have a doctor who wasn't creating jobs and would have a nurse or maybe two nurses, it's such a different world. I've created tens of thousands of jobs over the years. And so Trump is now paying some attention to Dr. Carson and
yes,
may continue to.
Well, we'll see how that plays out. You'll see how the people that have decided they rather like Carson react to that. There may be a lot of people who like Trump and like Carson. Will they like Trump more because he attacks Carson in kind of a, you know, kind of a mild and somewhat irrelevant way?
He had those two nurses.
Yeah, give me a break. I mean, you know, look, these two guys have one thing in common. Neither of them has ever worked a day in his life in public life. And at the moment, in this race, in this year, in the Republican Party, that's a distinct advantage.
That's right. And so what do you think, how important is the next presidential debate that we're going to see on September 16th with these guys?
It's about as, you know, it's as important as the next presidential debate can be. I mean, even after this next debate is over, it's still going to be early days. And we're still going to have a long way to go before anybody votes. And, you know, the candidates who have a lot of money have still not unleashed that much of it on themselves and on each other. So we got a ways to go here. I mean, this has been fascinating. It's been the summer of Trump, and maybe it'll be the fall of Trump and the winter of Trump, too. But I think we're a long way from being able to say that.
Last question before I let you go. The loyalty pledge. Good idea? Bad idea? What's the RNC doing?
Well, they're trying to make sure that Donald Trump doesn't stay in the race and then go third party at the end and take all his supporters with him and elect a Democrat. That's what that's about. And in Trump's position, you know, when you think about it for a minute, Megan, suppose he got the nomination, you know, with all his baggage and all the rest of it and all the not very conservative things that he's said and done in the past, wouldn't he want all those guys to have pledged to support him? I think he would. Mm-hmm. So maybe he'd be wise not to resist this.
Interesting thought. Britt, it's great to see you back again.
Yeah, thanks, Megan.
To be continued.